So we have the same goal, which is to create an awesome pizza application on Android. And now we've ended up with three feature lists, yours, mine, and yours. So what is the best set of features to end up in this perfect app?
So this is a really common problem that you as a developer have probably faced over and over again. You have all these really great ideas, so which ones are going to go into your feature lists? I can totally see a lot of people wanting to order the same thing every time, and I can also see a lot of people wanting to order fresh new things. So what are our two main options here? What is our solution?
Well, there's two things we could do. One is we could actually combine all the features and end up with an application that has 9 features. So yep. Maybe accommodating everyone's perspectives into account. Yep. Or another thing we could do is we could just pick one.
Yeah.
So basically pick either your or mine or your feature list and go with that.
So these are really both bad options because if you were to combine one or more of these feature lists, you're going to kind of have an application that doesn't really please anyone. When you try to please everyone, you end up pleasing no one.
Yeah, exactly.
And if you were to just pick one application that maybe would represent you or you, how do you know how many people out there actually have those same attributes? You could be missing out on a lot of different things.
So how do we solve this if both of these are not that good of an option?
Well, this is where user-centric design comes in. We design a product with a specific user in mind. So one of the keys to user-centric design is overcoming our own biases. So what we've experienced here is preference bias, that our own preferences are really being put directly into a feature list. And we're not designing for a user, we're just designing for ourselves. So next we're going to learn about another bias that we really need to be aware of.